Hey, Sedge, what are we working on today?
Okay, so check it out. We're organizing drawers today. I've always had these. These are what is known as French fitting a drawer. Okay, it helps me stay organized. I know where everything is. The Shakers had a saying, a place for everything and everything in its place. So check this out. If I'm using this and I just leave it somewhere, I open up the drawer and I go, I know what's missing. It's my center finder for my combination square. Same thing with this. This is my chisels that I've had in one big drawer like that for many, many years. And it also protects the edge of the chisel.
Gotcha.
Okay. And these are called French fitting. These are time consuming because you'll see little notches here where I came with a scroll saw. I took this chisel, I laid it on here, and I traced around it. And it was a fun thing to do because I know I've never lost a chisel and I know exactly where everything is. Okay, so today we're gonna do something a little bit different. I've been really stoked using this stuff. It's really simple. You buy this foam in different thicknesses. I buy it from Kaizen Inserts, okay? And today we're gonna trace, because look, this is one of the drawers I have in the same till over here. And this is, we have our cabinet scrapers, you know how to do that.
Oh, yeah.
The radius scrapers and my measuring and marking and layout tools, okay? So this, like I said, these are thicknesses. Now we're gonna do our saw till today. Or our saw drawer, okay? And here's the problem, I should have done this years ago, because guess what happens? Pulling that drawer in and out, I could be ruining an edge. So it's a protective feature for your tools.
Sure.
And I'll show you how to trace it. I will recommend this. I did this right away when I started doing stuff with Kaizen. I bought the entire kit. It's worth every penny because if you look here, you get all your different razor blades, you get replacement blades, you get these tracing markers, and you get this, they call it the holzer, but you'll see what it's for in a little while.
Sounds good.
Let's lay out our saw till and go from there.
Sounds good, let's go. All right, Sedge, so what's the first thing we gotta do here?
Okay, so you gotta decide what you're gonna have in that drawer.
Looks like you got it pretty well figured out,
okay,
to me.
So this is, like I said, it's gonna be a saw till. And the things I always do when I set this up to do it, I kinda wanna do it once. And sometimes I leave room because I know I'm gonna put extra stuff in there. This is gonna be quite tight. And what I always do is I make sure there's a perimeter around here as I'm placing my tools in. Okay, just like this. All right, because I want them, you gotta have some separation when we cut into the foam. All right, so I'll kind of angle that like this because I want to be away from the wall. Just like that, and just like that. Okay, away from here as well. I can move them forward, move them down, and have it just like that. The other thing I do is once I like this, I take a picture of it. Okay, just like that. Hey,
that's a good one.
Pretty good picture.
Yeah.
Okay. So what I did yesterday, this is a piece I have left over from a larger drawer. I got it perfect from front to back, okay? And I get a little room on side to side. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take out the tools, just like this, set them aside. And that's our piece of foam. I want you to see what it looks like as we tuck it in. Okay, now what I have found, sometimes I've had this happen before, there's little areas right in here. That makes a really great place if I bring it away from one side to put some rules or other measuring stuff in there.
Okay.
Okay, or maybe an extra replacement blade for this or something. Cool. So let's get started.
All right.
So one of the things I have found when we're doing this is I used to put it in the drawer and trace it. So what I do is I take it out like this. It's easier to cut. Set the drawer over here. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna go just like this, because it's gonna fit right in the foam like this. Like this. This is a thin piece. You can get them in different thicknesses. Okay, I think I had it like this, and then I had this saw like this, correct?
Yep.
Okay, now I'm gonna move this over a little bit more. I'd like to get that split nut screwdriver in there like this, because that is the one I'm always searching for. Okay, and then this saw file, okay? And what this is when you're, this is a little file right here, and this, when you're sharpening your saws, you just take that across a few times and that levels your tooth.
Nice.
So we'll put that in there like that. That's an antique one like this. Okay, so we get that, and let's get this over here. Okay, so what we're gonna do, and this is where you gotta be really careful because I'm kind of toward the edge there. Kaizen foam is really cool because when we trace this, you see how this is tilted? We're gonna cut this area a little bit deeper and this a little bit shallower because you can do them at different levels.
Oh, cool.
Okay, this one you'll see right here, same way. And then this, we'll cut this area here a little deeper. Okay, and this shallower.
Makes sense.
And this sometimes, like, if I've done things like this, like if we go back over here to the cabinet scrapers, I've only just used the razor knife to cut it in and stand it up. So it's just a really easy system, and you're gonna see how quick it is. So what we're gonna do is you're gonna look at this marker, okay? And I like to use the gold, okay? And we're just gonna put the tip like this and trace it. Whoopsie.
That's cool.
Okay, just like that. And you see how you can keep it. It doesn't have to be perfect, but, and I don't need, see how I'm going around the horn on this, mm-hmm. or the horns on this dovetail saw. Pull that off and let's look. Good trace.
Looks like a saw to me.
Okay, so I'll do one next.
Okay.
Okay.
Tag team, baby.
Tag team. I'll do this little Japanese saw. God, this has been with me forever. How's that look? We're in?
Looks like it.
Yep, we're in. There we go. Man, it's looking good. And now this saw set, I'm just gonna pull it up here. Okay, so there you have it.
Nice.
Okay, so the next thing we're gonna do is, this is why you have a bunch of different knives. Okay, this one here, look how small that knife is.
Oh, good.
That allows you to get really tight radiuses. So this is the way I do it. I've had some fairly decent success. I see a lot of straight lines. Now, when we look at the Kaizen, you're gonna see it's multiple layers and we're gonna pull it apart.
Okay.
Okay, so when I set my blade, this sometimes I'll cut all the way down. And then I'll monitor when we're scooping it out with our fingers, okay? Doesn't have to be perfect, okay? But I'll bring it right down to there, okay? Just so we have the depth I need. And I'm gonna do the straights like this, okay? And I'll monitor it myself and come back up. I don't wanna drag too much. We'll do some straights like this.
It cuts right through like butter.
Oh, it does.
It is, it's unreal. Okay, and I'll come over here. Okay, and as we look at this, see how I'm going down in there?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, that's gonna be my blade. Okay, and I've cut off quite a ways down there, so you just gotta be careful about the different levels
sure.
of pulling out. That's why sometimes you don't wanna cut all the way down. This Japanese blade is thin here and thick here. So the way I'm gonna do this is you get your finger in here like this, and go down till you think about the level you want, and you pull it back like this.
Oh, wow.
Okay, so that's exactly how I want it. See that?
Nice.
But I wanna go a little bit deeper. So what I'm gonna do for the handle now is I'm gonna make sure I'm cut in, but I'll go down, look, a couple levels or two, and you'll see how it fits. And it's just, there's all kinds of things you can get. I know some people who have a hot knife for this, or they have, a little tool you can put in a cordless drill that'll help flatten this and help cut it. I just want this to protect the saws and I don't need perfection. But if you do, you can, there's a little tamping tool you can get. So look at that, and there's the first one.
Oh, wow.
Isn't that cool?
That's freaking cool. That's awesome.
Okay. Okay, so we cut all the flats, all the straights, I should say. And what I wanna do is I did it on this one, I wanna do it on this one. Because of the offset of the handle, remember this is gonna be deeper, mm-hmm. and this is shallower. So what I wanna do, and does it really matter? Not really, but this is just fun stuff to play with. I'm gonna cut across the flat right there.
Okay.
Okay, because I'll just pull all of that out at a shallower. I did this one already. Now, we'll get the handle of the saw has got a bunch of different radiuses. And it doesn't have to be perfect. In fact, this one, we didn't even trace the center hole for the handle. We didn't have to, okay? I'm not trying to get ultra pretty with this. I just want to protect the tool, so I'm just gonna move this around so I can start cutting the different radiuses, and this one makes it nice. Great job on that. The next thing I'm gonna do is, this is where the handle is, you'll see it's offset a little, so what you wanna do is, see, I'll dig down a little bit like that. I'm gonna have you pull that out, but you gotta make sure you get your finger in there to get it level.
Okay.
Okay?
Haul a bunch out this time.
Yep, haul a bunch. Yeah, don't use your thumb back there, because now you start pulling it.
Okay. Gotta finesse it with the phalanges.
Yes. Let's see what the first round is with this. Dude, I'll take it.
All right.
Every time I reach in, I'll think of you, Big D. Okay, next thing we have to do is we have to realize, say that this is the inserts in the drawer.
Okay.
And sometimes you're going to do this and you're going to have like a lot of things really close together.
Sure.
And you don't want to, get frustrated trying to pick them out quick. Here, check this out. My fingers go right in there. I can pull out my saw, right? Here, I can pick up this saw file. Here, I'm kind of fumbling it when I'm trying to fumble. Here, I can just pick this out and put it in. So if I look at both of these handles, I could actually, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna take the holster and I am going to create an access point right here. And I'm just gonna go just like this.
Okay. What? That's cool.
So now, when I'm trying to pick this up, I go like this or this. And the nice thing about that, the foam comes right out. So let's get this now into the drawer and check it out. Okay, so as you can see, by the way, great job.
Had a good teacher.
No, yours is better than mine. Okay, you guys, this stuff is amazing. It'll get you organized. It'll look, now when I'm opening that drawer, it's always right there. I know I'm missing something. I'll say it 100 times. I don't wanna waste my time looking for something. This reflects back to when I was a kid. My dad had pegboard, and he had all the tools on the pegboard traced out, because he didn't want to waste time. And he knew, and he would ask my brothers and I, hey, where's the hammer? And we'd go, oh no. So we would always check before he came home that everything was on that pegboard. Guys, just get organized. It makes so much sense. So as we end this, like we always do,
be positive
and stay sharp.